just says that they're absolutely hungering down this point.
Yeah. Someone I know, his name's Kevin Broski. He lives on Bayshore Boulevard. You'll see in just a moment once this the camera stuff doing all of this. But basically, Kevin saw Bayshore just kind of suck all the water out earlier today. Kevin, are you still there?
Oh, did you watch it on the ground?
Kevin, so my first question for you is, I mean, you know Bayshore floods, you know the way that it floods. Why do you and your family want to stay through the storm?
That you can drive.
I agree.
Well, the bank part, this is all happening at night, so like, you're not gonna be able to see it. Oh, imagine all that recycling stuff that's being flying.
Oh, man. Any kind of updates they can give us about their more safe conditions there.
Oh, look at those cranes. Get the cranes over there. Let's get the cranes tomorrow. Like, come over here. Those cranes might not be there.
The message out here in Fort County EOC is that already at this point of the day, you do not want to be going outside, even though
you're
not seeing the full brunt of the storm yet.
What
they're saying, don't risk it. Oh, don't go outside at this point. They said, you know, it's just too dangerous. They don't want you to take that risk going outside. So far, the EOC says there has not been any major destruction so far with the vans that have been coming through Fulton County. Although Lakeland police have been tweeting out that there have been reports of trees down, they actually have some pictures they want to show you from an area of 1600 Sylvester, also in an area of Meadow Avenue. They have a few officers going to check that area.
That's not going to be there tomorrow.
Right now, we also have reports of trees down again on that Meadow Avenue
north
area at this point. I'm going to switch subjects. Your shelters have not been shut down quite yet, but Pete McNally, the director here, says that you really have to assess the risk when you're leaving the house right now to go out to that shelter. But we are learning that there is still plenty of space out of the shelters at this point. Polk County has over 38,000 spaces for people to seek shelter during this storm. And right now, I know that we have probably a little over 7,200 people that have went into those buildings as of yet, including hundreds of dogs and cats at this point. Again, though, they want you to assess the risk before going outside, saying that the winds are already picking up. Also, that the Citrus Connection is no longer giving rides to shelters. We want you to take a listen now to the EOC update from earlier.
As of this morning, the number of requests we had for transportation to shelters was about the max we felt we could handle with the buses on the streets before the wind will force them to come off. So we have ceased taking reservations for transport to shelters. Individuals that need to get to shelters are going to have to,
bags of
as the sheriff said,
see that?
Perhaps make other arrangements, either get there themselves or reach out to friends and family to help.
Right now, we have some numbers for you. We still have 19 shelters open up here in Polk County. Two are already closed. That includes Spook Hill Elementary as well as McHugh Academy. We have reports of another one, which is a special needs facility, which is Polk County Health Department, is nearing capacity, almost full. We do have a 911 reminder you guys were talking about earlier. Right now, they will not be sending out emergency vehicles once winds reach those speeds of 45 miles per hour or higher, just because they don't want to risk their vehicles. They don't want to risk their personnel at this point. But I have to say, I've been watching a lot of our reports out there. I'm really glad that our team here is at least seeking shelter inside the Polk County EOC. We're not standing outside in the winds and rain, so we're pretty lucky back here. And we will be reporting from here all night and through the morning as they plan on locking down this building once winds reach 45 miles per hour, and they expect those winds to keep up through at least 3 a.m. on Monday. Live in Polk County, Andrea Lyon, ABC Action News.
All right, thank you, Andrea. Federal search and rescue teams are now here in Florida. They are ready to move into areas after Hurricane Irma passes through. Reporter Paris Louvel was able to FaceTime with the director of FEMA to talk about what help is available for our state.
So not only are the local and state authorities preparing for the response, FEMA is also taking a key part of this. I'm talking with Mike Pruitt. He's with FEMA. Mike, tell me a little bit about what your response is all about.
So the urban search and rescue teams, and what we are in the process of doing is preparing to go to work with local officials here. We've already been involved in creating an urban
yourself where your bones are?
Hey,
on the beach. I'm just going down here just to see what they look like.
Thank you again for FEMA and a huge number of people here, and they will be helping.
Can't lock the window.
For ABC Action News, I'm Paris LaBelle.
Hey, you want a rubber chicken?
Sucked out!